So today I want to be talking to you about the myth of pregnenolone steal. So if you're exhausted and tired and you're looking to get your HPA axis up and running and having great motivation, drive, libido, energy, so that you can do all the things that you want to do in life, you may have heard of the term called pregnenolone, and you might have even tried pregnenolone. And I've even had a video that I explained about the concept of pregnenolone steal that is actually a myth, and I stand corrected because the research actually shows that it's not a phenomena. On this video, what I want to do is I want to explain what actually happens when we have stress responses that impacts our hormones and our cortisol and our DHEA, and explain to you what really goes on and what we need to do to overcome this. And I'm going to dive into that and explain everything that you need to know on this video. So let's dive in. Hi, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen, and I help exhausted and burnt out adults learn the truth about their health so that they can get their health back quickly. And today I want to talk to you about the phenomena of pregnenolone steal. So pregnenolone is a hormone. It's a precursor to your steroid hormone cycles, and it's made right after making cholesterol. And if you've ever done a saliva test or a hormone test, and you may have seen that your cortisol levels are high and your DHEA levels are low, and that's often been called a pregnenolone steal, which the concept comes out from the idea that our body makes a certain amount of pregnenolone, and there's only a small amount that you can produce for the entire day. And depending on the demands of the body, if we're under stress, you will steal away the pools of the amount of pregnenolone that you're making in a given day to be able to make cortisol. And it turns out that that's not actually true. What we find is that there are three layers to the adrenal gland. There is the glomerulosa, there is the fasciculata, and there is the reticularis. And ultimately, each zone is responsible for making a specific adrenal hormone. So aldosterone, cortisol, and DHEA. And that takes place in different regions in the adrenal gland. So what happens is when ACTH, which is signaled from the brain and it hits the adrenal gland, depending on what messages get signaled from what areas in the adrenals will depend on how much total cortisol output that is being produced. So you don't really steal a finite amount of pregnenolone from an overall pool, because each part of the cholesterol to pregnenolone to aldosterone, or cholesterol to pregnenolone to cortisol, or cholesterol to pregnenolone to DHEA occurs in separate regions of the adrenal glands, and therefore you're not actually getting a pregnenolone steal. Now, what does happen though, so why do you see a lot of the times in the short term and the midterm ranges of stress that cortisol will be higher and DHEA will be lower? And there has been studies that have been done on being run on whenever someone is under stress, or they don't have their blood glucose stabilized, or their insulin levels are elevated, or they have inflammation, it can actually impact some of the enzymes that convert cholesterol to pregnenolone to DHEA, such that the majority of the ACTH that's being stimulated from the brain to the adrenal glands prioritize the production of cortisol. And there's a lot of other mechanics that occur outside of the adrenal glands. So even though the adrenal glands may be preferentially producing cortisol in the short term, because the enzymes that produce the other adrenal hormones in the different areas of the gland are being blocked by epigenetic factors and signalers, toxins, waste products, chemicals, lack of vitamins and nutrients, it's like our body is programmed to prioritize the production of cortisol, but it's not a pregnenolone steal. It's more of a pregnenolone optimization or prioritization. But ultimately, the majority of the signaling of the hormones that are produced in the adrenals occur outside of the adrenals. So what does that mean? It means the brain has to signal to the adrenals in the first place, then the adrenals have to produce the hormone, then the hormone has to get bound to a protein, then it's gotta get into the cell, then it's got deactivated, or it's gotta be utilized. And all of those mechanics take place outside of the adrenals. And depending on the stress response that you're dealing with, depending on the inflammatory response that's going on, depending on the blood sugar stability of your body, depending on a lot of these variables, will tell the body how to communicate so that you're producing enough for the ring through the stressors at the expense of saving it for later, if that makes sense. So what I want to do on my next video is I want to actually explain to you how do you properly take pregnenolone? Has there been studies to show that pregnenolone is actually supportive and healthy? What's the difference between taking DHEA support and pregnenolone support? Can I take both? Should I take one or over the other? What tests do I need to be aware of before I start taking both? But I thought it was really important to make sure that you understand that it's not really a pregnenolone steal. You're gonna be able to produce the necessary hormone in the necessary amount, depending on the stress that you're dealing with. So if you're getting a lot of value, just make sure you like this video. And if you have a comment, make sure you put it in the link below so that I can comment and answer any questions that you may have. And I look forward to seeing you on our next video about DHEA and pregnenolone. We'll see you there.